There is a hot body which has a temperature T2 kept in an atmosphere, and the surrounding has a temperature T1 which is a lower temperature. Hot body T2, lower temperature T1. Then the hot body will be radiating out heat. Okay, and this temperature will start falling down. Now this heat quantity which is radiated out per second is given by this quantity dq by dt, rate of heat per unit time. This is known as rate of loss of heat. This per second will be depending upon what is the temperature difference here. If this is very cold, this is very hot, the heat radiated out will be very large. But if this fall of temperature is not so large, it is very small, then heat radiated will also be very small. Very simple logic. And this was first given by Newton, and it is known as Newton's law of cooling. So it says the rate of loss of heat of a body is directly proportionate to difference of temperature between body and surrounding. What is the difference of temperature? T2 minus T1 is the difference of temperature. T2 minus T1. What is proportionate to it? So proportionate to it is the rate of loss of heat minus dq by dt. This is proportionate to it. What is this minus for? It says that q is decreasing. That's why we put a minus here. The change is negative. Okay, because the heat is radiated out, so we put a minus here. So this minus dq by dt is proportionate to T2 minus T1. This is Newton's law. Newton's law. With this Newton's law, we can make a bit more derivations. Okay. If we want to make an equation, then this will be minus dq by dt, rate of change of heat, rate of radiation of heat is equal to, here we will put a constant k, this is T2 minus T1, where k is a constant which has got a positive value, that is heat radiated out. Now this dq, the heat, the state is not changing. When the radiation takes place, the heat goes out, the temperature will fall down. And some heat which has gone out, that is dq. How much is that heat calculated? How it is calculated? It is calculated by this formula. When heat goes out, there is a loss of temperature. This T2 decreases. How much? dT2. The small value of T2 decrease. If this is the change in temperature, then how much is the heat calculated? This is the formula what we have studied in specific heat in calorimetry. So heat is equal to M into S into change in temperature. MS dT2 is the heat radiated out. So this we can write here. This we can write here, and we get this equation as MS dT2 minus MS, this is dT2 upon dT. This is equal to K T2 minus T1. Now in this, we take the terms of temperature on one side and time on the other side. This is temperature, capital T, and this is time. So this leads to the equation. So we will take only dT2 upon T2 minus T1 coming here. T2 minus T1 is equal to dT will go here, K upon MS, and here dT. k upon ms into dt. Okay, now this thing, whole thing, it may be negative, no problem. Yes. Now this whole thing, this is a constant, mass of the object is a constant, specific heat is a constant. So this is again a constant, let's write it as capital K. And now our formula is dT2 upon T2 minus T1 is equal to a constant into dT. Yes. Okay, when we get this equation, what is this? Change in temperature, fall in temperature of the body. T2 minus T1 is the temperature difference between body and the surrounding. K is constant of cooling and dT is the time taken. With this, we can establish a relation between T2 and T1. How? Okay, let's integrate both sides. When we integrate both sides, what we get here is log T2 minus T1. This is power 1, power minus 1. So what we get here is log T2 minus T1. This is equal to, here this will be, yes, minus, this minus, we keep the sign, minus k and dt as integration t. So this is minus kt plus constant for integration. Log t2 minus t1, that is integration of this, because this is t2 minus t1 to the power minus 1 into dt. So that is log t2 minus t1. This is kt, constant of integration. Now, if log of this quantity is equal to this, then what is this quantity equal to? So we have here is t2 minus t1 is equal to e to the power minus kt plus. Okay, that means e to the power minus kt multiplied by e to the power c. And e to the power c we are writing as c dash. So we get here t2 is equal to t1 plus. So if we know T1, this temperature, if we know T2, this temperature, then we can always find out T if K is known to us. If T is known to us, we can always find out what will be T2 after time T. So this is the relation which tells us about T2, T1 and time. So this is Newton's law of cooling, which gives us, here you will see, for initial time when the temperature difference is very large between the two, the temperature falls very sharply. If the temperature falls, the difference becomes less. If the difference becomes less, the rate of falling becomes less. So for first so much time, this was the fall. Again for the second so much of time, this is the fall. The fall has become less. And if we see the third time, same time here, the fall is only this much. So this, for the same time, for the first interval, the fall is large because the temperature difference was large. For the second interval, the temperature difference has become less. It has cooled down. So the rate of loss dq by dt has become less. The temperature fall is less. Third time the temperature fall is further less. So this is Newton's law of cooling. Thank you.